मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, तो इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई वाज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट माइक्रोइकोनॉमिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मेरिडियन प्रोफाइल एंड इन दैट रेफरेंस आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट हाउ पॉलन सैक प्रोसीड टुवर्ड्स मैच्योरिटी. तो इन दैट लेक्चर आई डिस्कस that in primitive stage, when the pollen sac or microsporidia is in developmental stage, at that time it consists of archisporial cells. Archisporial cells, they undergo repeated mitotic division to form two concentric layers of cells, but the outer one is called parietal cells and the inner one is called sporogenous cells. Now further, the cells of parietal layer, they divide by mitosis cell division, and the newly formed cells, they form another four concentric layers of cells, which I have told you that is epidermis, endothecium, middle layer and capitulum. But there is no division in sporogenous cell. Now it is the turn of sporogenous cell. The pollen sacs or microsporidia, they consist of meristematic cells, which are known as sporogenous cells, and since they are in group, so they are also known as sporogenous tissue. Now each of the cell of sporogenous tissue, means each and every cell of the sporogenous tissue, they act as, means now division is going to start in them. And each of the cells of sporogenous tissue, they act as MMC, that is microspore mother cell. Means there are more than 100 of sporogenous cells in a pollen sac, and each of them are known as microspore mother cell. We will be call it as PMC, pollen grain mother cell. Microspore mother cells, they are also known as pollen grain mother cell, or in short we call it as PMC. All these 100, more than 100 cells, they act as microspore mother cell or pollen grain mother cell. The pollen grain mother cell or microspore mother cell, they are diploid, means they have complete paired set of chromosomes. So here only one cell I have shown you, but all, means this division, means all the microspore mother cells, they undergo cell division, and the division here is meiosis cell. So a diploid microspore mother cell undergoes meiosis cell division, and after completion of meiosis cell division, four haploid, I have represented here N. N means you have already studied about diploid and haploid curves in class 11. So here four haploid microspores are formed, and these four haploid microspores, they are known as tetrads. We call it as tetrads. And all these microspores, they remain joined together. All the haploid microspores, they remain joined together by a cementing material, by a adhesive material, and that adhesive material we call it as callose. So callose is the cementing material by which all the four haploid microspore tetrads, they remain joined. After few time, this adhesive material or cementing material callose, they disintegrate, means they break, and all the four microspore tetrads, they get separated from each other. So after separation, each of the microspore again undergoes cell division. Each of the microspore, they again undergo cell division. So here I have shown you microspore, separated microspore from this tetrad. Each of the microspore, again they undergo cell division. So I have shown you single microspore, but all the four microspore undergo cell division. So here now microspore, they undergo haploid microspore. These microspores are haploid. these microspores are haploid, and haploid microspores, they undergo mitosis cell division. They undergo mitosis cell division, and as a result of mitosis cell division in the microspore, two unequal cells are formed. One is larger inside and other one is smaller inside. But both the cells, they remain joined together. The larger cell, that is called vegetative cell or tube cell. The larger one is called vegetative cell or tube cell. It is known as tube cell because after pollination, this vegetative cell, it forms pollen tube. Pollen tube, and it is an important structure which helps in fertilization. So the larger cell, that is called vegetative cell or tube cell, because it forms a pollen tube, and the smaller one is called generative cell, and both of them possess nuclei. Now this partially divided microspore, that is known as pollen grain, and pollen grains are only known as male gametophyte. They represent the male gamete of the flowering plant. And pollen grains, they are also known as male gametophyte. Now, students, we will study the detailed structure of mature pollen grain in our next lecture. Thank you and good.